Okay. Today, world, we have a lot of huge problems that we can't solve. Overpopulation, human rights, climate change, food security, water security, and so on. But I think we have an additional problem set on our hands, which is the food waste. Food is wasted in a colossal scale. So what happens here is that I found that the food waste in Kuching is really a lot, and then what we're trying to do is we convert it into something else. Oftentimes, what we don't know is that we, as an individual, you and me, also contribute to the food waste stage. But the problem is that the Prabi, after I read through all the comments that written by the Prabi on the wall, the Facebook wall of that shopping mall, I found that there's a lot of misunderstanding, or they don't really aware on what is the food waste stage. So you and me are actually the contributor to the food waste stage. Oftentimes, the things that we don't eat, what is off the plate, what we do with that, we actually throw it into the rubbish bin and we feed to the garbage bin. So what happened here is that the garbage man will actually help us to collect the waste away from the house, from our housing area. From our housing area, and also they will send 100 miles away from our house to the place we call as dumping site. So that dumping site is actually in Malaysia, we call it as a landfill site. So what happens is that when we send out the food and we send out the solid waste to the landfill, there is two major pollutants that we produce. The first one is the landfill gas, which is known as a methane gas. It's actually a very strong, powerful greenhouse gases that can cause a rapid climate change. As well as the second pollutant will be the leachate. It's basically rubbish water that can actually pollute our groundwater and our waterways. This one is the proper landfill that we have in Malaysia, but the fact is in Sarawak we have 46 dumping sites, but only 5 of the out of 46 is the this kind of landfill. The rest is called open landfill, which is some sort of the rubbish dump. So what do we do with the rubbish dump is that we just clear out of a piece of forest, and then we throw out all the trees, open the lands, and then we dig a big hole and we just dump in everything that we don't want, and then we cover it with soil. And that can actually cause the environmental pollution because the methane gas is not treated in the proper using the proper facility. The leachate and the dust there, that actually can pass through down the soil, and then they will pollute our waterway. So our food waste can actually divide into two big parts. The first part is the food loss, whereas the food loss is actually happening in the farm. So it's not really related to us. But for the food waste itself, is actually is produced by the consumer, which is you and me. So we can get the food waste from the food scrap, from our plant, and we also have the kitchen waste from the restaurant, hotels, and even school. And we also have the distribution center, whereas the grocery actually produce a lot of food waste. So just give you an example on the food waste stage. So this one is the pictures that I take from one of the hotels. It's not a hotel, it's a restaurant, it's a Japanese restaurant. So what they did is actually they have the salmon meal. So they cut off the top part of the salmon and the bottom part of the salmon, and then the leftover is the middle part, the backbone with some fish on it. So what they do is they just throw it away, and that creates the food waste. And not only that, the food peels, the veggie leaf, and expired food are all under this category. And when we go one step up, what happened here is that we go to the grocery and we see the food is really big, nice, and is delicious. But what we don't see behind that is this. What is this? Obviously, it's a watermelon, but yeah, it's this watermelon. But we actually rescued them from one of the dumping site of one of the supermarkets. So what happened to them? They're actually fresh, they're still edible, and they are good to eat, nice to eat, but just because of something wrong. So that reason is really ridiculous. So let me show you. It's because the size is too small. And because the size is too small, they just throw it away for nothing. And why don't they just make it into watermelon juice, right? But they choose to throw it away. So that is the things that are really, really come back with. So it's not only this. Also, when we talk about the environmental, or when we talk about the ecological limits, we need to admit that, we need to recognize that our planet is actually facing the ecological limits that it can bear. So we have to do something else. We have to do some changes. So what I did is actually I get one people to help me. It's from biotech, a biotech student to help me with kick off this project, and then I call off the ministry, local ministry, to help us to launching our project. So after 3 months, we actually, from two people, we grow into millions of workers and volunteers. Do you believe me? Some people say I'm lying, so I take a picture and I show to them. Yeah, this is the worms, it's my workers and volunteers. So what they do is, they actually help us to reduce the food waste. So normally we collect the food waste from the restaurant, hotels, events and school. And then what we do is we bring to our farm. We have the fry farming. We bring it to the farm and then we let them to help us to convert and decompose the food waste for us. And after that, after end of the day, we can get the first one is the protein salt as a worm itself is a bioprotein. And then second one is the fertilizer. It's the ready compost that ready used for the plantation. So the amazing part for this fry composting is that there is two benefits. The first one, this fry only live for 7 days. Mean to say after the 7 days, they will die. So they have no energy to disturb others, they have no energy to spread the disease, unlike the normal house fry. So they are considered as non-pets. So with that, the second one is the worm itself, the maker itself. So the maker itself can actually reduce the food waste in a very fast manner. So for example, 1 ton of the worms, we can actually reduce 1 ton of food waste within 1 day. So it's really, really fast. It's 1-to-1 ratio. So compared to the traditional or conventional methods, which take up 30 to 60 days. Meaning to say our method is 30 to 60 days faster or more efficient than the conventional one. Yeah. So I done my part. How about you? So first thing, the most important thing is reduction. So the reduction, whenever you go hang out with the friends and then you go to restaurant, hotels, what you can do is you normally order the food, right? So if you can't finish the portion, what you can do is you share with your friends, right? So share with your friends and to reduce the food scrap and the surplus food. And then the second is buy smart and choose smart. So normally we go to the supermarket, we see the buy one free one offer. So before you buy it, make sure that you are able to finish it before the expiry date. So that is one of the ways, not only saving the food, but also saving the money. And the third one is choose local. So what is mean by choose local? Meaning to say we choose a local food, local produce instead of the overseas. Because when they send the food from overseas, they need to take care of the distance, and then maybe some of the food will spoil. And then also when they transport from the overseas to the place that you live in, they actually produce the transportation wise, they actually have the carbon footprint. So choose local instead of buy overseas or buy the import items. And then the number four is the buy organic. So some people say that buy organic is expensive, I can't afford that. So well, I think you can go ahead, fine, because you can whether choose premium or you want to pay to hospital because of the pesticide leftover, right? So the last one is the composting. So this one is the most important one because everyone can do our job. Where you can have, if you have the garden, you have the backyard, what you can do is get your waste and then you just dump it to your backyard, or you can do some sort of compost site at your backyard. So some people say that they don't have the they live in condominium, they don't have the backyard. So how can they do? So never mind, you can buy a bin and then you just dye in everything, and then you can search online, buy in some microorganism, then you can put in, then they can help you to reduce the food waste without any smell. So you don't worry about that. And after all, the compost that you produce at your homes, at your house, what you can do is you can do your self farming. So you can produce your own food, organic food, without any chemicals. My name is Jeff from Warming Up. Thank you very much.